Hey, what's up? I'm X. Welcome back to the Four Idiots series, the series where I teach you how to do a boss as quickly as possible. Please like and subscribe and comment so that this video gets recommended when you search for Huey Codel Guides. Let's get right into it. The only quest that you'll need to get here is the Children of the Sun quest. Head over to the top of Darkspire Mountain here, and if you'd like some more information, talk to the dwarves for some lore. For gear, you're going to want to maximize your offensive crush damage and strength. As of this moment being day of release, it's assumed that Inquisitor with your scythe on crush is going to be the best, but Dragon Hunter Lance on crush also seems to work well. This should be a zero damage fight, so you'll need minimal food. You might want a stamina, prayer potions, and some food. Thralls and Death Charge will also work, but please remember to bring whatever you have. Before we get started, if you're looking to do smaller teams for better drop and pet chances, then I'd encourage you heading over to this flag here and creating a private instance for yourself and friends. When you're ready, head past the chains and wait for the dragon's body to poke out of the five holes in front of you. When they do, start hitting them with your best crush offense until they die. While you hit them, you can be hit with two attacks, however. You'll see these throughout the fight, so be aware of them. There are these little blue circles which will hurt you if you're on them when they activate after just a few seconds, or these flying shards here that only you can see and you have to pray against before they reach you. Green for range, blue for mage, and red for melee. Hit the holes until all five are dead. Once they're all dead, a previously blocked gate will open, allowing you into the fight. Before you run in, take note of how many players you have on your team. This is relevant as during this fight, there are three pillars in the northwest correlating to range, mage, and melee. When you pray the respective overhead to the pillar will fill. If the NPC in front of the pillar's yellow bar fills all the way, when the pillars are filled all the way, you'll get a massive damage buff and the braziers will light. The reason the players that you have matters is you need to divide the work evenly. If you have three players, you'd do one prayer each. If you had six players, you would do two each, and so on. If you have an odd number above three, however, it doesn't seem like it matters much and the additional two can just kind of fill in where they need to. That being said, the boss doesn't actually have any direct attack to pray against, so just run and crush it. The previous attacks will still be occurring, so be aware of them. At 50% of its HP, it will spawn its tail on the west side of the arena. When it does this, it will also create a little shockwave attack. This attack is really all that will damage you throughout this fight, and it's kind of finicky to avoid. You can tile skip it when it's 2 to 3 tiles from you depending on where you are in the wave, so like this. Just click it when it's 2 tiles away from you, and more often than not, I was fine, but also don't sue me. Hit the tail, and if you don't have a lot of DPS, it will change sides. There's a timing to clicking the other side and avoiding the shockwave. I just go when the tail is no longer attackable on one side, and that seems to work out perfectly just like this. It's also very important to note that the tail has a very low damage cap, so using fast attacking crush weapons like the ham joint or the dual Makoetl are actually better than the Inquisitor Mace or the Scythe here. When the tail dies, get back on the boss just as before. The only thing that will be different is there will be an occasional shockwave attack sent at you, but nothing new aside from that. The drops will scale based on your team size, so if you're looking for uniques or pets, then I'd recommend finding smaller teams, but however you fight this boss, I wish you luck. Thanks for watching, I'll see you next time. Like, comment, subscribe, and nobody can pronounce this dragon's fucking name.